every payment, transfer, or claim has to pass a single question. Is this fraud, yes or no, before the money moves? And we usually have less than 200 milliseconds to decide.
And that's why banks lean on AI models. They watch for patterns, learn from history, make decisions fast. And when an AI model is unsure of how to rate a given transaction, fraud or not fraud, the request can be escalated for human evaluation. But multi-model AI is changing that.
Exactly right. Most fraud detection platforms today, they begin with traditional machine learning models. So let's call these predictive ML. We're talking about algorithms like logistic regression and decision trees and random forest.
And don't forget my favorite, gradient boosting machines.
Oh, how can we forget those? Now, these models, they're trained on large labeled data sets of past transactions. Some of those are fraudulent, some of those are legitimate. And that's so they can recognize patterns that indicate fraud. So for example, a gradient boosting model, yeah, that might use dozens of features like transaction amount and time, location, merchant category, and user spending history in its analysis before outputting a risk score.
Yeah, lots of well-defined structured data that the model can process and access, which ultimately gets to an evaluation that answers the question, is this transaction fraud or not fraud? But novel or subtle fraud tactics can evade detection if they don't trigger one of the known indicators. And also, these models generally ignore unstructured information, like freeform text, descriptions, and images entirely. Cases with any of these attributes or where risk assessment is uncertain typically get escalated for manual review, since the automated system can't conclusively classify them.
Which brings us to an ensemble of AI.
I was wondering if you'd ever get to that. So ensemble being multiple AI models?
Yeah, exactly. A second AI model for fraud detection. So in addition to the predictive ML, this second model uses transformer-based large language models, and these are, yeah, encoder LLMs.
Thought you might say that. And so we're clear here on the distinction, a decoder LLM is a generative AI that can generate new content based on given prompt, so chatbots and things like that. Whereas an encoder LLM is a non-generative LLM that focuses on natural language understanding. It's great for understanding text, classification, name entity recognition, and sentiment analysis. Models like Bert and Roberta, a lovely couple.
Aren't they just? And an encoder LLM is a great fit for fraud detection, as these models can grasp nuanced language patterns, they can detect contextual clues, and they can extract key information from unstructured data.
For example, a bank might use an encoder LLM to read the description of an online funds transfer. If the text says, refund for overpayment, please rush, well, the model might detect urgency and phrasing common in scam scenarios and assign a higher risk score. Or an encoder LLM could analyze the merchant name and freeform address for signs of spoofing or association with known fraud cases, which is something a traditional model might not capture.
So let's compare the two, predictive ML and encoder LLM.
Predictive ML loves structured data and numbers. It's well-suited at spotting sudden card-not-present spikes, bursts of spending, geolocation jumps, impossible travel scenarios, and things like that. Anything you can measure in neat columns or in whatever those are.
That's structured data, Jeff.
Of course.
Now, whereas an encoder LLM, that can read between the lines of unstructured data, so images and the like, and I guess this is like a mountain vista?
Of course. Does he like that better?
Much better, much better. So think of a wire memo that says, urgent investment, guaranteed 200% ROI. That's a pretty obvious indication of a scam to human eyes, and also to an encoder LLM, because both can recognize linguistic patterns associated with fraud that don't nicely fit into a spreadsheet column.
In the pros column, predictive ML has certain advantages. For instance, microsecond latency. It's cheap compute requirements, and it's simple scaling and easy to follow audit trail.
Whereas the pros for encoder LLMs are being, well, context aware, and being language savvy, and then being surprisingly good at connecting dots, even in situations that humans might miss. A good encoder LLM can greatly reduce false positives because it understands why something looks a bit fishy.
In the cons column for predictive ML is being that it's pattern bound. A new scam using clever wording slips right through the defenses unless you craft manually a new sort of detection scheme.
And then the cons for encoder LLMs, well, they're more computationally intensive than simpler ML models. They have millions or billions of parameters, and they require significant processing, often with GPU acceleration to run inference.
So that begs the question, how do you use these two types of AI models in an ensemble solution?
So let's build a multiple model AI fraud detection workflow to answer that. So we're going to start at the top here with a box that will represent incoming transaction data.
All incoming transactions first go through the predictive model. This model, using ML algorithms like random forest, receives structured data and generates a fraud score based on probability of fraud and a confidence level.
At which point we assess that confidence level at this stage here. Now, in most instances, the model's output's pretty clear cut. Either the score is well below the risk threshold, so it's likely legitimate, or it's well above it, so most likely fraud. And when the model has a high confidence level either way, the transaction is routed straight to the final decision. That's where an action is taken. Either the transaction is auto-approved or it's flagged as fraud.
It's the low confidence, ambiguous transactions that trigger the second stage. When the predictive model returns a score in the borderline range, indicating uncertainty, the system will not immediately decide. Instead, the transaction is escalated to an encoder model, LLM, like BERT, for further analysis.
And the encoder LLM, that receives the original structured features, but it can also process any unstructured data or contextual information that's available. So that could be like the transaction's description text or customer profile notes and the like. And the encoder LLM, it ingests this composite input and it compares it with millions of fraud patterns using a deeper context-aware lens, outputting its own LLM assessment.
The final decision engine combines the LLM findings with the original model's input. So a transaction that was borderline might be definitively flagged as fraud because the LLM uncovered incriminating text. Or it might be cleared because the LLM found the context to be innocuous.
So in this architecture, straightforward cases, they're processed with minimal overhead, while trickier cases, they get kind of a second look through the AI rather than being immediately handed off to a human evaluator. By not sending everything through the LLM, the system stays efficient. This costly LLM here is only run when necessary.
And by using the LLM on truly ambiguous cases, the system improves overall accuracy. Fewer legitimate transactions are falsely flagged because the LLM can recognize a benign explanation, and fewer frauds slip through because the LLM can catch subtle cues the first model missed.
And this can really save a lot of time and resources. So let's consider insurance claims processing. When a natural disaster hits, well, lots of claims, they're all kind of filed at the same time, and insurance agents are probably going to need to put in a bit of overtime to process the high number of claims coming in. And there's probably a bunch of unstructured data in these claims here. So images of property damage and stuff like that. Now, an ensemble of AI model solution using an encoder LLM that can look at that unstructured data here and it can extract insights like the cause of the claim and the urgency.
And the predictive model can automatically rank and auto-adjudicate incoming claims, together reducing the burden on insurance agents. A bit less overtime for them.
But there is one more important piece, and that's the infrastructure. Because running these multiple models in real time, especially something as compute-heavy as encoder LLMs, it requires specialized hardware.
Right. You need a system that can handle low-latency inference at scale. Ideally, right at the point of transaction. That's where things like AI accelerator chips come in. On-chip AI acceleration support workloads like this, allowing fraud detection models to run directly where the data lives.
So while the models do the detecting, it's the hardware that makes it all possible, especially when you're aiming to catch fraud in milliseconds and, well, not minutes.
So that's the multi-model AI for fraud detection. As fraudsters devise new tactics, banks and businesses need to respond with smarter detection.
And a multiple model AI architecture combines the predictive power of traditional ML here with the contextual reasoning of large language models.